Hello dear students, how are you? This is Dr. Keshari Shukla and today I am going to deal one of the most important poem written by W.B. Yeats. Students, this is Easter 1916. Students, this is very remarkable poem and it was written in 1916. You know, that actually this poem has a historical importance, especially from Ireland. Students, the poem when it was written, in those days England was ruling over Ireland. Actually Ireland was just surviving under Britain, as it was Great Britain in those days. And from 1870 the struggle was started. Revolutionists came in Ireland and their effort was in a single direction, to make their country free from the hands of Englishmen. And when in 1914 World War was started, so Britain just proposed Ireland that in this World War just cooperate me, just fight from my side in this World War. And after the World Wars, when the World War will be over, so I will make you all free. Your country will make free. This was the treaty. But you know that the English revolutionist has just lost their patience, and it was the day of Easter in 1916. You know that Easter is very important festival which is celebrated in Christian countries, especially this is very famous festival of Christians. So on this very day, students, all the revolutionists just started revolt against British Empire, against Britain, and this was the day Easter, which is celebrated in the England on the pious occasion, in the memory that this was the day when Jesus Christ just came again. As you know that he was crucified, he was killed, and he just took rebirth. So this is celebrated in the memory of that event when he just got revival. So on that pious day, all the revolutionists just started a revolt against England, and on Dublin they have controlled. They got victory and they have just declared Dublin as their own kingdom and formed a you can say that a government they have formed there within no time, although it was a temporary government. But although it was World War just going on, even then by the power of army, Britain again just got victory over Dublin. And you know that the trial was just done in the court. All the revolutionists were just captured. The trial was done in the court, and you know that 1600 more than this number people were just executed. They were just shot dead. They have been sentenced to death and they were just shot dead. So in the memory of this incident, this terrible incident, W.B. Yeats has just written this poem, Easter 1916. So here W.B. Yeats is telling that so many men who were just involved there in that revolution, in that rebel, you can say, yeah, you can say that it was a rebel. तो द मेन हु वर जस्ट इन्वॉल्व देयर फ्यू वर एक्वेंटेड मीन्स फ्यू वर जस्ट फैमिलियर टू डब्ल्यू बी ईट्स मीन्स इवन डब्ल्यू बी ईट्स वॉज देयर इन दियर कंपनी एक्चुअली व्हेन फ्रीडम फाइट वॉज स्टार्ट इन आयरलैंड तो इन द बिगिनिंग डब्ल्यू बी ईट्स हिमसेल्फ वॉज जस्ट अगेंस्ट इट बट इट वॉज द इफेक्ट ऑफ मॉन्टगोन यू नो आई हैव ऑलरेडी जस्ट मैंशनड अबाउट मॉन्टगोन सी वॉज बिलवेड ऑफ डब्ल्यू बी ईट्स तो इन द इम्प्रेशन ऑफ मॉन्टगोन ही ऑल्सो ज्वाइंट दिस मूमेंट एंड देर वर टू ग्रुप्स वन ग्रुप विच वॉज जस्ट ट्राइंग टू टेक दिस फ्रीडम ओन किंगडम ओन गवर्नमेंट बाई स्ट्रगल एंड स्ट्रगल ऑफ फाइट एंड वन वॉज जस्ट फॉलोइंग द वे ऑफ गांधी जी दैट यू कॉल नरम दल तो दिस वेरी मैन डब्ल्यू बी ईट्स वॉज इन नरम दल एंड मॉन्टगोन वॉज इन गरम दल मीन्स मॉन्टगोन वॉज जस्ट इन द कंपनी ऑफ दोज हु वर जस्ट offensive in their approach but the way of this very man W.B. Yeats was different means both were in different stream but their single target was to just get freedom from the hands of Britishers so here W.B. Yeats in this poem is just describing few characters who were just involved in that and these characters are only the representatives Not he has just mentioned everything about that struggle, especially the struggle which took place on that very day, Easter 1916. What kind of atmosphere was there? And to just describe the atmosphere, he's giving some characters who were just involved there, who had just thrown themselves in this movement and just involved themselves firstly in that. So among them, few characters were very important as Constance Markovich. The first character is Constance Markovich. She was a young woman. She was just described in this poem. Second, Patrick Peters. He was a teacher by profession and poet also. He's described in this poem. And another character is MacDonagh is another important character and another very important character John McBride a village boy drunkard kind of man these characters are just mentioned here and now we actually in this poem let me introduce you about the basic concept of this poem in this poem W.B. Yeats is trying to say that those men who were very common in common days in general days in common days in daily life those men who were very common and ordinary kind of men just as W.B. Yeats himself was common practices were there in their life not extraordinary men were they were all the men who just involved there they were very common kind of men their practice their life everything was very simple but on that particular day Easter 1916 they were just in different getup Their life approach and application was totally changed. A very terrible kind of atmosphere was presented, and they all were very, very offensive in their mood. And they all were in unite form. They were struggling for freedom. The students, he is telling about those characters. So you are supposed to just open your text. I am going to just teach you this poem. The starting of this poem, never shall a young man thrown into despair by those greed honey colored. No, dear students, actually this is another poem we have started. Sorry students, actually I have started different poem. Yes, Easter 1916. We are now just going to just teach you students. So, starting is, I have met them at close of the day. what characters I have described to now W.B. Yeats is saying that I have met them, I used to met them daily in the evening. I have met them at close of day, coming with vivid faces from counters just at desks among grey 18th century houses. Now W.B. Yeats is telling that we have met all those faces whom I am just watching in this moment. So this in our common lifestyle, in our general lifestyle, I used to visit them daily in the evening, as we all used to go to market for sabji, for vegetable shops. So generally we used to visit the men there, the common men there. The very same kind of lifestyle were there of those men who were just extraordinary today, but they were very common kind of men. W.B. Yeats was totally familiar to them. I have passed with nod of the head or polite meaningless word. He is telling that I generally used to wish one another nothing special, and generally in wishing was not also very hot. I mean, in ordinary we used to just wish one another good evening, how are you? In general way, we used to just behave with one another. And he is telling that I have lingered a while and said polite meaningless words, means what kind of just conversation just went used to went on in between us. This was meaningless, not very useful. And though before I had done of a mocking tale or a grip to please a companion, his telling that generally we used to talk in very light way, some jokes were just exchanged, means very light kind of atmosphere I have just passed with them, whom we are watching today in very different getup and approach on this very day, Easter 1916. Students, further he said that around the fire at the club, being certain that they and I but lived whether motley is warm, but he is telling that today their approach is totally nationalistic. What special kind of nationalistic approach, nationalistic blood which is boiling in their veins now today, totally changed getup today. Now, very important phrase, all changed utterly. W.B. Yeats is telling that everything was changed on that very day, on the day of Easter. Nothing was like earlier. He is telling as the earlier practice he has just described in the beginning. So these kinds of things were not there. Totally everything was changed on that day. Their getup, their approach, their application, means everything. Means they were totally surrendered themselves only for the freedom. They have just dedicated themselves. They are ready to sacrifice themselves for the freedom of Ireland. He is telling that all changed bitterly. A terrible beauty is born. He is telling that although everything was terrible at that time, but there was a beauty in that terror, and it was the beauty of that kind of passion. Everyone was just fighting in united way for the freedom of the country. This is the beauty of unity. But this was a terrible atmosphere on that very day. That woman, now he has started describing about those characters. The first lady, the Constance Markievicz, the first lady, he is telling that woman, they were spent in ignorant goodwill, her nights in arguments. See, he is telling that the first character, Constance Markievicz. Constance Markievicz, she was very ordinary kind of lady, ordinary kind of girl and a lady of the society, who used to just spend her hours in useless arguments, very common kind of, as you know, the common behavior or common behavior of ladies. They are very much talkative, the very same kind of talkative, ordinary lady she was. And ignorant goodwill, her nights in arguments until her voice grew still. She was very talkative. She used to speak very much till her just throat stops working. Very talkative kind of girl. What voice more sweet than hers? He is telling that no voice was as sweet as the voice of that particular lady, that particular girl. But today, in this moment, her voice was totally changed. No sweetness is there, only harshness. Just slogans were just pronounced there. He is telling when young and beautiful she rode to harriers, means she was a horse rider. She used to just ride horses. Very common kind of lifestyle, especially in the ladies of England, 18th century ladies. Very same kind of lady she was. But today, her everything was changed. And now the next character, this man had kept a school and rode off winged horse. His other the helper. He is telling that the next character is Patrick Pearse. He is a school teacher and poet also. Very soft-hearted man. He used to teach the students. And another his friend was also there, McDonald's. Yes, McDonald's was another his important friend. He was the friend of Patrick Pearse. He was also involved there. Was coming into the force. He might have won fame in the end. They were very famous. Famous for their ordinary life, not for this kind of revolutionary act, but in the profession where they were, means as a teacher, as a poet, they were famous. They have no already any kind of background of fighters, but today their spirit is totally the spirit of a fighter. They were in very same kind of mode as in Victorian age. I have told you about Alfred Lord Tennyson and Robert Browning. I was ever a fighter, so one fight more. This kind of spirit was there among all. Yes, he might have won fame in the end. So sensitive his nature seemed, so daring and sweet in his thought. They all were very sweet in their thoughts, very emotional and very emotional kind of thought they were. But today they are very daring kind of personalities which were shown only in this moment, students. And after that, another important character, John McBride. John McBride, you know, that he was already related to W.B. Yeats' life. Yes, yes, he was very same man who was involved with Mordgon. So some jealous kind of feeling W.B. Yeats has for this very man, John McBride. The other man, I had dreamed, a drunken, yes, vainglorious, lout, means all the bad qualities John McBride had. W.B. Yeats is telling that he was not a very courageous man, but he was a foolish drunkard kind of man, and he had done most bitter wrong. He is telling that everything he has done wrong, especially with me, because he had just snatched Mordgon from the hands of W.B. Yeats. This is the concern of W.B. Yeats actually. He has done everything wrong. W.B. Yeats is telling actually, this is the man. I don't like this man, John McBride, because he has done everything wrong with me. He is the man because of just my beloved Mordgon, whom he was actually loving. One-sided love it was, you know. So he is telling that he is the man who has snatched. He has done everything wrong. To some who are near my heart. Yes, near my heart means Mordgon. The Mordgon was very near to the heart of W.B. Yeats. Is telling that he is the man who has snatched someone who was very near to my heart. It was none other but Mordgon. But yet I number him in the song. But he is telling, but I am just putting this very man among those men who were just in different kind of approach on that very day. He was also involved in that company. He is telling, he too has resigned his part in the casual comedy. He too has been charged in his turn, transformed utterly. He is telling that he is also involved there, and totally everything was changed there. The atmosphere was totally and totally changed there. They all were just fighting for a single purpose. It was the movement, it was the freedom for Ireland. And again, terrible beauty is born. Again, he is saying that it is very beautiful moment. It was the freedom fight. But a terrible atmosphere was created on that particular day, Easter 1916. He is telling, a terrible beauty is born. Yes, hearts with one purpose alone, through summer and winter scheme enchanted to a stone, to trouble the living stream. He is telling that all are different groups. They all were the representative of different class of society, but they have single target. The single heart they have and single target they have, it was to just make Ireland free. The stream which was flowing in Ireland, it was the stream of Britain. They wanted to just make Ireland away from this stream of Britishers. They wanted, they are in single direction, single hope, single target, single goal, it was the freedom of Ireland from the hands of England. The students, this kind of approach they all had. Yes, the horse that comes from the road, the rider, the birds, that range from clouds to tumbling cloud, means a very terrible kind of atmosphere. The nature imagery has been presented here, and now the scenes, how the horses, how the men riding horses and telling slogan, and they are ready to sacrifice for the freedom of Ireland. So here some terrible kind of atmosphere has been presented. Minutes by minute they changed, and minutes by minutes, at every moment, at every next moment, the things are getting hotter and hotter. The atmosphere was becoming more terrible and terrible, offensive and offensive. Very terrible kind of atmosphere was there. A shadow of cloud on the stream changed minute by himself. A horse hoof slides on the brim, and a horse places within it a long, long moor. Hence, tribe, and hence to moor. Cock's call is telling that everything was totally dispersed there. Only the thing which was united, it was the group of the men who were struggling for the freedom of Ireland. Students, minutes by minutes they live. They are living in a single moment, and at every moment they are ready for the sacrifice. They are living for that particular moment, and it was the moment of the freedom of Ireland. The stone in their midst to fall. Too long a sacrifice can make a stone of hurt, or when minutes suffice. He's telling that a long time has passed. Actually, as I have told you, that they all have been just killed there after the trial in the court, when they were just arrested. This moment was smothered and crushed by the Britishers. He's telling that they all just sacrificed their life for the freedom of Ireland. They can never be just forgotten. The role, the importance of these martyrs, these sacrifices, that can never be just forgotten, can make a stone of the heart. They are right or they are wrong? This is a question. Ki they have just made a revolt. It was right decision or wrong decision? They is telling, but their role, their work, their practices can never be forgotten. Students, that is heaven's part. Our part is to murmur name upon name. He is telling that only God knows, only heaven knows, ki they have just took right decision to make revolt against Britishers, or wrong decision it was. Only God knows what would have happened if they were just if they would have did their promises they have kept, that it was right decision. Otherwise it was wrong decision. Only God knows what would have happened. They is telling, but my duty is this: just to pronounce their name with respect and honor. Our part to murmur name upon name, as a mother names her child, and we have same kind of love for them as we are pronouncing their name. We are calling them with the same kind of respect as a mother calls her child. Very same kind of a land is also mother, and the men of that land are the children of the mother. He is telling that as mother with love and sweetness calls her child, very same way I am just remembering them in very same kind of emotion. We have when sleep at last has come on limbs that has run wild, what is it but nightfall. He is telling that it was nothing more than that terrible dream what was just seen, but although it was not successful at that time, but it was the beginning, it was a starting, and very same kind of respect we have, although on that day it was not the fruitful result, but even today we have the same kind of respect for them. O limbs that has run wild, what is but nightfall? No, not night, but death. He is telling that their death, what we were just remembered as what night, actually it was a death. They all have died. They have sacrificed themselves for the freedom of Ireland. And he is telling that was it needless death after all? Now W Beats putting the question, they have sacrificed, was it right? They have done for right purpose, their decision was right. This is a question mark for you. You have to understand. Yes, students, manjil mile na mile, manjil ki justaju mein karwa to hai. So they also serve only stand and wait, as John Milton has said. Your duty is to just have courage. Your duty is to fight. Winning doesn't matter. You have fought well, it matters. Students. So they have tried for their freedom. That's why they all are remembered today. He's telling. And for England, may keep faith for all that is done and said. Is what I have just made you clear, that if English would have just kept their promises, it was a wrong decision. But what was the belief? Actually, it has just gone into the depth of the past. So nothing is very clear to say what would have happened. We know their dream enough. But W. Beats is telling one thing that everybody is very convinced and clear about, that we all know the dreams of those men who sacrificed their self for the nation. Their dream was to get victory from the cruel hands of Britishers. They wanted their own government, their own governing body in Ireland. He is telling that we know their dreams. Their dreams was to get victory. Enough to know they dreamed and are dead. And this is enough what they have dreamed. And this is enough for us to know that they have fought for Ireland. And they are dead now, unfortunately. And what is excess of love bewildered them till they died. They have the same kind of feel for the nation till they died. I write it out in a verse. He's telling, W. Beats is telling, that I am just writing this verse in their respect, this poem in this respect. Mac Donack and McBribe and Connolly and Pierce, we are writing in the respect of these characters who were just involved their self, just thrown their self for the freedom of England. And now the time to be where your green is warm, he is telling, till the flag of the green flag of Ireland will remain on the forts. They will always be remembered or change utterly. A terrible beauty is born again. W. B. Yeats is telling that really I am still remembering that the day can never be forgotten. Very, very special, very terrible atmosphere on that day. But it was very beautiful moment because it was the moment of the freedom for the Scotland, for Ireland. For the freedom movement of Ireland. Although they didn't get success, but it was a nice moment. And he is telling, till the green flag of Ireland will remain on the forts and walls of Ireland, the importance, the role of those martyrs can never be just forgotten. So this is the poem I have just taught you, my dear students. Now, the stylistic devices, what I want to just make you clear, the meter what has been used here, the two kinds of meter has been used in this poem, iambic tetrameter and iambic trimeter. First iambic tetrameter, then iambic trimeter, then iambic tetrameter, then iambic trimeter in successor. So this kind of meter they have used, and rhyme of the poem is ascending. In ascending order means in ascending order this poem proceeds. The rhyme of this poem is in ascending order. Excellent kind of feeling and imagery is there. Terrible beauty, as W.B. Yeats has just described, the terrible beauty has been just presented in this poem. Very emotional kind of approach, what the common life of men in the beginning, W.B. Yeats has presented of those great martyrs. What kind of common feel of common life W.B. Yeats has tried to just make. And also W.B. Yeats has just given the feel of some offensive type of feel. He has just presented some bombastic kind of feel by the language. He has tried to just make clear how the strugglesome atmosphere was there, was that on that particular day, Easter 1960. So all that has been just presented. A visual imagery has been presented by W.B. Yeats in this poem. It seems that really this is happening before us. This moment is just going on before our eyes. But dear students, in this way, I have tried to just make this very clear, this poem. With this, thank you. Thank you very much, dear students.